Hello everyone, this is Dr. Ashish Vanmali and welcome to the video lecture on how to solve the problems of KL transform or Hotelling transform. So before we actually go for the problems, let's see the important steps that we need to follow. So step number one is to find the matrix U. So for that, first we need to find the matrix A transpose. Then we need to find the eigenvalues of A transpose. And for each of these eigenvalue, we need to find the corresponding eigenvector. Then we need to normalize the eigenvector that we have followed. And then we will form the matrix U. So columns of U will be normalized eigenvectors of AA transpose. And here we consider the columns will be arranged in the order of maximum to minimum eigenvalue. So when you start finding the eigenvectors, it is always better you first find the eigenvector of corresponding the highest eigenvalue, then the next highest and so on. And then those will become your first column, second column and so on. Okay. The same steps we will repeat to find the matrix V, except that over here we are finding the eigenvectors or the normalized eigenvectors of A transpose A. So here we will first find A transpose A. We will find the corresponding eigenvalues of A transpose A. We will find the corresponding eigenvectors. We will normalize them. And these normalized eigenvectors of A transpose will form the columns of B. And after that, we can find the transformed image, that is capital lambda is equal to U transpose A V, where A is the image, U and V are the matrices that we have found as explained above. Now let's revisit the basics of eigenvalues and eigenvectors. So to find the eigenvalues of matrix A, okay, we first define what is determinant of A minus lambda I equal to 0. And we solve this determinant. So there will be some equation that we will get in lambda. So we solve it and find the roots. Okay, and that will be our corresponding eigenvalues. Okay, so in this process, once we find the eigenvalues, what we will do is we will arrange them in the maximum to minimum order. Okay, the next step will be to find the eigenvectors of A. So for each lambda, we will solve A minus lambda I into x equal to 0 or Ax equal to lambda x. Okay, and we find the corresponding eigenvectors of eigenvector x. And then we normalize it. So to normalize eigenvector, okay, let's consider that E is the eigenvector that we have, which has the elements as e1, e2, e3 up to en. Then the normalized value of the eigenvector is given as en, which is E upon L2 norm of vector E, where this L2 norm of vector E is given as square root of E1 square plus E2 square, so on up to EN square. Okay, so this is how we do the normalization. Now, let's go for the actual problem. So, over here the question is, obtain the KL transform of image A, and there is a 3 cross 3 image given over here. So, if you observe A, it is 10, 2, 3, 2, 4, 0, 3, 0, 1. Okay. So if you observe carefully, then the rows of the matrix are same as the corresponding columns. Okay. Or we can say A is symmetric. So we have A as same as A transpose. Therefore, when we find the product AA transpose, it will be same as A transpose A. Okay. So over here, when you substitute that value, you'll find that matrix as 113, 28, 13. 28, 26, 33, 6, 10. So this will be my AA transpose. And since AA transpose is same as A transpose A, the eigenvectors of AA transpose will be same as the eigenvectors of A transpose A. And hence our matrix U is going to be same as B. Now to find the eigenvalues of AA transpose, which will be same as the eigenvalues of A transpose A, we'll write the equation. Determinant A transpose minus lambda I equal to 0. So I is our identity matrix. Okay, so whatever AA transpose that we have, okay, along its principal diagonal, we will have minus lambda term. So it will become 113 minus lambda, 20 minus lambda, 6, 33, 6, 10 minus lambda. So we have added this, whatever the diagonal term, minus lambda over here, that is equal to 0. So we find the determinant of this matrix. So over here I have written the expression for the determinant, and when you open up the corresponding brackets, you will get the final equation as minus lambda raised to 3 plus 143 lambda square minus 1681 lambda is equal to 0. Okay, so for this equation, whatever the roots will be our corresponding eigen values. So if you solve for it, you will get the three values as 130.0769, 12.9231 and 0. So I have arranged these values from highest to the lowest value. So this will be my corresponding lambda 1, lambda 2 and lambda 3. Now we need to find the eigenvectors for each of the lambda. Okay, so over here again, since we have A same as A transpose, we will have whatever the eigenvectors of A transpose same as A transpose A. So over here, first we'll solve for lambda 1, that is 130.0769. So we need to solve A transpose minus lambda 1 I into X is equal to 0. So we substitute this lambda 1 over here. So lambda 1 is 130.0. So I will have this equation as 113 minus 130.0769, that will be my first diagonal term. The second diagonal term will be 20 minus 130.0769. And the third diagonal term over will be 10 minus 130.0769. The remaining terms will remain as it is for AA transpose. Okay. And over here I will have the vector x, the values x1, x2, x3, which will be equal to zero vector over here. Okay, so when you do this subtractions, you will get that particular matrix which is shown over here. Okay, now we need to solve this. Okay, so how to solve it? Okay, so over here, okay, what we will have is there are three terms that we have. So I will have x1, x2, x3 over here. In the numerator, alternatively, I will have a plus minus sign. So I will have the first term as plus, second term as minus, third term will be again plus. If I have the fourth term, it will be again minus and so on. Now the denominators over here, okay, are determinant skipping that particular column and the last row. So if you go back, okay, so if I consider for the first column, okay, so I will skip this first column and I will skip the last row. Okay, so I will be left with 28, 33, minus 110.08 and 6. So I will find the determinant of this. Okay, and that determinant will be over here. Okay, for the first term. For the second term, I will be considering second column. So over here, okay, I will skip the second column and the last row. So I will have minus 17.08, 33, 28 and 6. Okay, so these will be my four terms, and for that I will find the corresponding determinant, and that determinant will come in the denominator of the second term. Okay, similarly for the third term, I will consider the third column. So I will skip this third column and last row. Okay, so these are the four terms I will have: 17.08, 28, 28, minus 110.08. okay, so corresponding determinant will be coming over here in the denominator. Okay, so now whatever the signs, if there are any cancellations, you can cancel it. So over here this minus and minus will cancel. Okay, so in the denominator I will have this term, the term over here without minus sign now, and this term. Okay, and I will form a vector corresponding to it. Okay, and that will be my eigenvector 1, that is u1 over here. Okay, so this first term comes over here as the first element, second term comes over here as the second element, Okay, of course I cancel the sign over here, and this third term comes over here. Okay, but our job is not done over here. We still need to normalize it. Okay, so to normalize, as we have already seen, okay, we have to divide that vector by its L2 norm. Okay, so first I will find the L2 norm of my vector u1. Okay, so my L2 norm of vector u1 will be square root of the squares of addition of the squares of the different terms. Okay, so it will become 1308.64 square plus 1026.48 square plus 1096.16 square. Okay, and whatever the sum, I'm going to take the square root of it. Okay, so finally we will get the answer as 4086.58. Okay, so this is my L2 norm of vector u1. Okay, so I divide my vector u1 by this L2 norm. So when I divide it, I will get those values as my normalized vector or normalized eigenvector u1, that is u1n, will now become 0.9301, 0.2514, 0.2683. Okay, so if you observe the value of the normalized vector, all the elements will always have a value which is less than 1. Now we will repeat the same process for the second eigenvector, that is lambda 2. So over here the lambda 2 is 12.9231. So we'll write the equation A transpose minus lambda 2 I into x equal to 0. Okay, so we substitute lambda 2 along the diagonal. Okay, sorry. So I substitute the lambda 2 value along the diagonal. So it will become 113 minus 12.9213. That will be the first element of the diagonal. 20 minus 12.9231. That will be my second element of the diagonal. And 10 minus 12.9231 will be my third element. The remaining elements will remain as it is. Again, we will have the vector corresponding to x and the vector corresponding to 0. If we do the subtraction, this is what the matrix we get. And now we will repeat the process as we have done earlier. Okay. So in the numerator, I will have x1, x2, x3 with alternate plus minus sign. So x1 will have a positive sign, x2 will have a negative sign, x3 will have a positive sign. And in the denominator, we will have determinant of skipping that particular column and last row. So for the first term, I will skip the first column and the last row, and whatever is left over here, these four elements, I will find the determinant that will be coming over here. For the second, I will skip the second column, so this column will be skipped, and the last row, so this is the 1, 2, 3 and 4 are my elements for which I will find the determinant, and that will come over here in the denominator of the second term. And for the last term, I will skip the third column and the last row, so I will be left with these four elements over here. I will find their determinant, and that will come over here. Cancel the signs. So over here I will cancel the sign of the second term because I have negative sign in both numerator as well as denominator. And when I write my vector u2, that is my eigenvector 2, it will be minus 65.64 plus 323.52 minus 76. Again we will normalize it. So I will find the L2 norm of vector u2, that will be square root of minus 65.64 square plus 323.52 square plus minus 76 square. So that answer will come out to be 338.75. So divide each element of u2 by this L2 norm. So we will get the corresponding normalized eigenvector as u2n is equal to minus 0.1935, 0.9553, minus 0.2237. Now we will repeat the same process for lambda 3, that is equal to 0. Okay, so over here I will substitute the value along the diagonal. Since it is 0, I will have the same matrix A transpose over here multiplied with a vector of x, which is equal to 0, and correspondingly I can find the eigen vector of it. Okay. So over here you will get that eigen vector 3, that is u3, as minus 492 plus 246, and third element will be 1476. Again, to normalize it, we will find the L2 norm of u3. Okay, so over here it will become square root of minus 492 square plus 246 square plus 1476 square, and that value will come out to 1575.17. So divide each of this element by this L2 norm and we will get that value as minus 0.3123, 0.1562 and 0.9370. Now once we have found all the normalized eigenvectors of U, we can form the matrix U. Okay, and of course, as we have already seen that in this particular case my U will be same as V. So it will be the first column vector u1n, then I will have u2n and u3n. Okay, so this is my first normalized eigenvector, this is my second normalized eigenvector, and this is my third normalized eigenvector. Okay, I also found my u transpose over here. Okay, just for my reference. Now we will have the transform image. Okay, so the transform image, that is capital lambda, is given as u transpose a v. So we will substitute what is u transpose, whatever is the a and whatever is v. And when you multiply these matrices, so it will be a matrix multiplication that will perform. So multiply these two matrices first and whatever result you multiply with this third matrix. Okay. So when you perform this matrix multiplication, you will get the final answer something like this. Okay. Now if you observe carefully, or a simple verification that you can always do is, whenever you have a KL transform, the transform image capital lambda, okay, or the matrix that you will get will be always a diagonal matrix. That means you will have only non-zero terms only along the diagonal, and all the other terms over here. So if you see these three terms or these three terms, they will be always zero. Okay. So in this case, my diagonal elements are 11.4051, 3.5949, and the third element I got over here as zero. Okay. So this is my transformed image. Now just for verification, let's perform an inverse transformation over here. So the inverse transform will be A is equal to U capital lambda V transpose. Okay, so if you substitute and if you solve for it, you should again get back your original image. Okay.